So when you say VI, okay, I'm just trying to say emp1 dot, or let's say dpt dot txt. And when you say VI editor, it will open a command mode here. So this is the place where you can type your text in the editor here. So mostly you don't need to too much worry about this, because in the Hadoop always your data will be supplied to you, and then you will be taking and then pushing onto HDFS cluster. But at the same time, sometimes as part of the configuration, you may have to open some files and then make some changes. So that's why the VI editor, I'm just showing a couple of commands how the VI editor works. Okay. So whenever you want to create a file and then make some entries into the file, you can just say VI and then your file name. And then once you get into this, everything will be showing like a tilde. Means so you are not in a position to write anything. Even if you type it, you cannot type anything. In case you want to type, you have to take the VI editor into a insert, means edit mode. So that you can do by using two options. Either you can press I button right now by opening. So right now I'm pressing the I button. Okay. And the moment when you press I button, okay, and it will be opening this editor for us to make some entries. So right now I just pressed on I button. So I'm just typing it. So like this, you can keep typing your information. Okay. And once you type your information, and normally up and down and all that you can use the do by arrow down, up and right down and arrow button. And once you type your information to save the content in this particular file, so you have to say colon. So now I am typing colon. Okay. So see, now since I am in a edit mode, insert mode, so when I type colon, automatically the colon character has been inserted over here. Okay. But I'm just deleting it. Whenever you want to save this file, first you have to come out from the edit mode. Right now we are in edit mode. I press the I button and now I am in the edit mode and I can type anything from the keyboard. But if you want to write and do save your file and then do other special commands or execute other commands, in that case you have to come out from the edit mode first. So that you can do by pressing the escape. So right now I'm pressing the escape button. When you press escape, now you are come out, you have come out from the normal mode. Okay. Right now you have just come out from the edit mode and then now you are in the normal mode. So now I can say colon. So now that you can see that colon is typing over here. Whenever you are not in edit mode, if you type okay colon command, that colon command will be coming over here. Otherwise, if you are in edit mode, okay, and then if you say type colon, that will be typed in the normal file wherever your cursor is placed. So right now I came out from the edit mode. I am in a normal mode. That is generally in Unix it is called escape mode. I pressed colon, and when I say type W, okay, and then just say enter, so then it can say that W stands for, okay, writing, means saving the file. So it says that your dpt.txt has written, means your file has been saved right now. And if you want to make any changes in this file, again you go back to the edit mode. I can press I button, okay, and then you can start typing anything. And now if you want to again save it, come out from the edit mode by pressing the escape button. So now I am pressing, if you now directly type the colon, you will see colon in the editor itself. But now I am pressing the escape button. By pressing the escape button, you will be coming to the normal mode. Now if I type colon, it will be typed in the bottom, and now I am again saving W. Then it will save. And if you want to save and come out from the file, you can say W, okay, and then Q. So this will save your file and come out it will take you outside. So right now, it will save and then take you out. If you want to only take you outside directly from this particular file, you can just say colon Q. Only colon W will save the file. Colon Q will take you outside. Colon WQ will save and then take you outside. So now I am saying colon Q and now we got outside. Now if you see cat dept.txt and it will show you what content you have there. This way you can make the file operations within the VI editor. Okay. And not only that, in the VI editor, okay, you can also do some other one or two important commands I can tell you. If you want to delete any line, okay, you can say dd. DD command will delete a line, okay. And if you want to insert a character at end of the line, you can say capital A will take you last one, okay. And if you want to display the information in the file, okay, with numbers, line number, you can say set NU, okay. It will just display the line numbers for you, okay. And one of the other important commands, set list, okay, the set list will command will display you end of the line where. So generally in case you want, if you want to find out the junk characters in a text file, in your file, if you use set list command, it will show you, okay, let's say where you are exactly end of your line. In between, if you have any junk characters, those will be revealed within the file here itself, in case you have anything, okay. The same way, whenever you want to do any search and replace, okay, again colon percentile s, okay, colon percentile s is a command, okay, that is for search command, okay. So I want to search some value, let's say wherever apple is there, I want to replace it with some mango. So I'm saying percentile s, okay, then what do you want to find out? Apple, I want to find out. So this value I want to replace with a mango, okay. So you can say again forward slash and g. So this will go and replace, search for apple words in the entire file and then replace it with mango. And the g represents globally. Globally means when you don't give g, it will go and search. It will replace the first occurrence of the apple to mango. So right now we have only one place apple. If you have, it will go and search here. Okay, this will get replaced by mango. But if you have one more apple, okay, and it will not replace it to the mango because you are just, whenever you say without the G, okay, it will go and replace the first occurrence only. But whenever you want to replace the entire file wherever apple is there with the mango, you can say G, that stands for global. I'm just saying yes. So now your apple has gone replaced with the mango. Okay, in the entire file wherever it is there, it will get replaced. So these are the common commands you can use it. Okay, and WQ I'm saying I'm coming outside. The same way sometimes, okay, now you want to, I have made some changes, let's say. And now, since I have made some changes, if I say Q, okay, I'm asking to come out, but I have made some changes. And when you say Q, it will say, okay, no write since, add to override, okay. And since you have made some changes, okay, now I want to, whenever you want to come out, you have to either decide, save and come back, or if you want to come back without making those changes to your file, so you can say colon, if you say WQ, it will save and then come back, but I don't want to save, but I want to come back, in that case you can say Q star, sorry, exclamation. So when you say Q exclamation means you are just forcefully quitting out, means in this case it will not save any operations. So these are the common commands, not important, but in case anybody interested, because you may don't have to do this one, okay, because even lot, we have lot of other tools, okay, whenever you want to make any file operations, okay, you can do it on the Windows itself and then place that file onto the Unix machine. So in the worst case, if you are not comfortable on these VI commands, okay, still you can get that file into your Windows machine, do the changes and then send back to your Unix. So that is mostly people will do. Okay, so now just to talk about the VI. Okay, VI is an editor. Okay, so I So these are the common commands. If anybody interested, you can try. Otherwise, you can ignore it because this is something related to editor command. So now we are talking about the cat. So these are the files we have. So I'm just say cat. Okay. emp.txt. You will see the data in this one. Okay. So now when you say cat-b and then your file name, cat-b will display the data with the line number. This is all the data, and this is 1, 2, 3, 4, your line numbers. Okay. And the cat also can display data of one or more than. Let's say, for example, so I have two files. When I say star.txt, I can see two files. Okay, one is dept and one is emp. And when I say cat star.txt, it will display the content of all the files. So whatever files you get matched with this pattern, right now there are 1, 2, 3, 4 are there. So when you say cat star.txt, it will display everything. Okay, even when you say cat-b star.txt, so it will display everything in the 1, 2, 3, 4 line. So this way, cat command displays the content of one or more than one files here. Okay, and in the same way, when you are working on cat, when you are talking about the file operations, you can also try to display. Now I am just saying cat emp.txt. This is the file here. So now in Unix we have two special commands called head and tail commands. The head command in a Unix will display top line. Let's say I want to display only two lines from this particular file. You can say head-2 and then give your file name. Head will display the first two lines. It will not sort the data. In as is, whatever content we have, it will just display first two lines. And when you say tail, the tail is another command. Again, this is also file display command only. So it displays the bottom two. So this is the bottom two and this is the first two. So sometimes if you want to display a particular line number, say right now I want to display only third line. Okay, so whenever you want to display third line, what you can do? Okay, so I can say, since I am looking for the third line only, so when you say tail-3, it will display all first three lines. But since I am looking only for the third line, so this is 1, 2, 3 records we have here, but I am looking for only this third line. Since I am looking for this third line, okay, so since already we know in yesterday's session we discussed there is one pipe symbol which will help you to combine more than one Unix commands. So now what I am doing, I am just saying head 1, 2, 3 we have. Okay, so first, second, third line, three lines we have, but I am looking for only this one. So on top of this output, what you get, I am just keeping a pipe symbol, and then now I am saying tail-1. So now we already know that this head 3 will give you first 1, 2, 3 records. Now I am saying tail-1. So when you say tail-1, the tail command will be applied on these three records output. So tail means bottom one, so it will give you the last record here. So this way, using head, get the first record, tail, bottom record. And then, if you want to pick up a particular line number, also you can do using the combination of head and tail. So this way, the cat command will display the content, and also in the same way, we have other commands also, which are like view more, that is also display. And in the same way, we have few more commands which is called head also. Head displays. And the same way tail-n displays And also whenever it is trying to display, it will not sort the data. If you have some records, it will go and just pick up the first or bottom records, but it will not do any sorting or it will not do anything. And this command can also be used to get nth number. Okay, you can say head icon n will give you the head those many numbers. And I'm just saying 5 and tail minus 1. Okay, so this will give you the nth line number. So this will give you first and bottom. And if you want a particular number, you can just take the head icon n and then you can give the combination of both. Okay, so both can be done over here. I have this file. When you say cp, okay, it is equivalent to copy command. I just want to copy emp. Okay, to this particular new file. Okay, cp command copies the file, and the same way, okay, now we have one more command. Let's say when I say cp, and I'm just saying dbt to dbt1. Okay, this will keep the dbt file and then it will copy a new file. But when you say move, move is another command, it is equivalent to rename. So now I want to rename dpt1 name with okay, after copying, whenever you copy a file, okay, now we have a dpt, okay, and also we have a dpt1 because we have copied. But now what I am doing, I am just saying move dpt1 move to dpt underscore mv. So now if you see, your file got renamed, okay, remaining all everybody is there, but dpt1.txt got renamed to a different name. So move can be used to rename your file, and not only that, whenever you change the name of the file by placing it in the same directory, it will be acting like a rename. But at the same time, I can also move these files from one directory to other directory. Okay, and I can also move the file from one directory to other directory, or I can just place the file in the same directory and give different name. So the second case will be acting like a rename, and the other case it will be really physically moving your file from one directory to other directory. Very simple. Okay, you can just copy or move a file. Redirection operator. So what are redirection operator? Say for example right now, so I have the data like this. So now I am saying one command. Okay, when I say ls command, it is giving me a list of all the files. Whenever any command output, whatever command you write, okay, if the command output, by default, whenever you fire it will be displayed onto the screen. Right now it is displaying. Whenever you want to redirect your output, whatever is thrown by your command to a different file, okay? So what you can do, you can just say command, and then rather than displaying this output, I want to redirect the complete output which comes from here to a new file, okay, any file. Okay, so the complete command output, whatever, generally what you get onto the screen, now I'm trying to redirect to a different file. Okay, this is called a redirection operator. So now if you see, a new file has been created, And now if you see the data, you can see the complete list in this one. So all the file names, whatever we got from here, these file names has been written to this particular file. So this way redirection operator can help you to redirect your content to a different file. Okay. The same way, now I have some data, cat star dot csv, we are doing it. Okay. So this entire output, okay, now rather than taking to the screen, I want to redirect to the so all the output which we got, which is content of all these files, okay, cat star dot txt, the complete list, okay, now is going to be returned to this new file. So now you will not see anything on the screen, but this output has been redirected to a particular file here. So now when I say cat, okay, now complete content has been returned to here. So there is a new file created. This way, less than always, okay, sorry, greater than always, redirect your output of your command to the other file. At the same time, less than operator will take the output of any file as an input to other command. Okay. So right now I don't have example. And later on the shell scripting part I can show you example. Okay. So generally, whenever you are planning to, okay, take, let's say I have one command here, let's say, okay, I want to take the input for this command from another file. Okay, so it will not work right now because, okay, because it is not a right command. Okay, so this kind of commands can be done. Okay, so right now, it says that, okay, cat emp. So it is taking the output of this one. Okay, but when I say ls, the directory is not available. So I am saying ls of whatever output comes from this every particular line. So that we don't have any data, that's why it will not work. So generally we'll be using, okay, the greater than symbol that will redirect your complete file from your output from your screen to a different file. That is one of the useful ones. Okay, and the same way, so right now I'm just you can also display, say we know that echo, okay, welcome. Is one command, generally display onto the screen. Same output rather than you taking, okay, now I want to display to the file f1.txt. Now if you say cat f1.txt. If I execute again the same command, again it will take that file and then it will override the data which is there in the f1. If I see cat again, you will see the same data. But when you use this option, okay, double redirection operator. So in this case, I'm using double greater than symbol. In this case, what happens? It will append the data of the current command to the existing content. So previously, we already have one line in this file, okay, and then when I use this command, whatever output you get from here, this output is going and then overriding on this particular file. So by losing it, okay. So but when you use this command, it will keep your previous content, it will preserve it and then it will append it. So now if I say cat, you will see two lines because it is a previous line and it is a current line. So this way double redirection can concatenate, okay, append the data, okay, and then so less than operator redirects. Example ls okay, without losing the existing content. Okay. Okay, now I have two files. Cat, you can give multiple files. EMP1, I want to do this way. So like this, you can start giving multiple files also. Or you can also give E star. This we already seen. This is one we have a name. Just a additional note. Now, have some data here. Let's say cat emp.txt. Okay, so to make some arrangement in the file, I'm just editing the file. Yeah, I will. So now cat will just display the content. But in case you want to sort the data, you have a command called sort. Okay, you can say sort emp.txt. It will sort your data. So now it is sorting on Apple. All Apple came together with data and then hi. So both and then lastly welcome. Okay. The sort command can help you to sort data. Okay. And also when you use a combination of U, insert sort to U, okay, and then EMP, when you say this, it will also eliminate the duplicate. So right now we have two to Apple, but only one Apple, big data, and hi is two times, one time, and then welcome, one time. Okay. Sort will sort the data, and then sort type on U will eliminate duplicates also whenever it is sorting the data. So both you can do. And in the same way, we have one more command called UNIX. Okay, so UNIX generally tends to, okay, again, remove the duplicates, means display only UNIX records and avoiding the duplicate. But only the difference is when you say UNIX, it will try to avoid the duplicates, but before avoiding, it will expect your data to be in a sort order. So when I say UNIX, since the current data is not in a sort order, so it is not in a position to identify who is duplicate. Okay, because I don't know, Apple is here, Apple is here. So always it will do line by line comparison. First and second records, if they are same, if both are same, then it will eliminate, it will consider it as a duplicate. But right now they are not in sort order. So that's why, okay, it is not working. But if you use a combination, let's say I am saying sort, emp.txt, okay, it will sort the data, and then I'm just saying UNIX, that we already know we can combine the data, sort emp.txt and then saying UNIX. So now sort anyway will sort the data, and now I'm applying the command UNIX. Okay, then it will work like this. So now sorted and UNIX. And one. So what is the advantage of the UNIX is, UNIX has few more options. Okay, so right now it is obvious, absolutely distinct UNIX record. But when you say D, UNIX D, okay, it can help you to display the records which are only duplicated. When you say UNIX, it will display all these 1, 2, 3, 4 lines. But when you say UNIX -D, it will display which are only the duplicated ones. Okay, there are two records duplicated, and then only that record you can see. Not only that, you can say UNIX, when you say WC, okay, only C, it will display every line how many times repeated also you can see. Okay, now when you say UNIX and C, D means it will display only duplicated record. C, it will display the count, every line how many times it is repeating. Apple, big data, welcome, hi, how many times it is repeating you can see. Okay, and when you say DC, it will display only the duplicated lines. This will be very, very useful command, especially when you are working on data quality. So if you want to find out which is duplicate and how many times it is duplicate, and all that, you can get it very easily from this command. Okay, so that way sort command can help you to example sort mp.txt. Sort type on u, okay? Sort and display only UNIX. And the UNIX command display and the UNIX -d display only duplicated record. So these are the normal UNIX commands. It will give you the complete how many lines we have and all that. When you say WC minus L, it will just give you the line guard. So 6 lines we have, 34 characters here. And also the 6 lines, because we don't have any UNIX, the duplicate, the other kind of unwanted records we have here. So this will display the number of words and number of characters and the number of lines here. The 6 is the line number here. Okay. So you can sometimes use to quickly check how many number of lines we have or how many number of records we have using the WC or WCL command. It is very quite calm. Let's say I want, we know how to create a directory. So mkdir, okay, I'm just saying d. And now you can see that the directory created by name d. If you want to remove directory d, it will remove. And I'm going to create a file, okay, d.txt. And if you want to remove a file, rm d.txt. Okay, it is asking me to delete, confirm. But if you want to remove forcibly, it will not ask for a confirmation, it will go and remove it from RM directory, will remove the directory. And rm minus f, rm remove the file. and we have emp.txt. Okay. So now I want to search how many times Apple, whether I have a Apple word present in the emp.txt. So now I am saying grip and I am looking for Apple word, and then this I want to search in the emp. So this will work like a search. And whenever you are searching, so the same command can also be written like this, cat emp.txt and grip Apple. So both are 100% same. Okay. In case you want to get multiple files output, you want to search, you can do. Let's say I can also do this way. I can say star.txt and then search Apple. So in how many places you have file, it will give you. Okay. So this way, either you can write this command or you can write this command. And whenever you use these commands, okay, when you say grep, grep -v, okay, will do a negative command. So just to simply make you understand, okay, now I am doing this grep command, grep apple emp.txt. It is giving you the matching lines only. And when you say grep -v, okay, it is a negative searching. I want to display all the lines which are not having the Apple word. So now it is showing the negative. iPhone V is a negative. So normal is a normal. And when you use N along with this Apple and the grape, it will display the line numbers. In entire file, we have so many lines. But for which lines, okay, Apple is present. In which line it is present? So 3 and 5. In 3 and 5 lines, your grape or Apple word is there. And if you use N and V, okay, then it will display what are the records which are not having Apple and their line numbers, you can see here. In the same way, when you say grep H, okay, it will display the file names. Okay, right now, okay, it is just picking up your word here and then it is displaying the file name here. Means I am searching for a value Apple and I want to see, okay, what is the file name also here. So in this case, it may not be useful because anyway you are searching only one file. It should be anyway in this file only. But whenever you are using this, let's say cat star dot txt I am typing and then say grep -h apple, then it will display the cat star txt. In this case, it is getting data from here. And not only this, you can also do this grep iPhone H and Apple, and then I'm looking for star.txt. Okay, so now this is the file star.txt, and Apple is there in EMP1 and EMP and EMP file, and in these files we have this. And also when you see the number, okay, in EMP file in line 3 we have Apple. In EMP also line 3 Apple, okay, line 5 Apple again in the EMP, here is a 15th line and then it is a 19th line. So this way you can find out the line numbers also. This way H will give you the file name and then N will give you the line number, V is a negative condition. And when you use iPhone L, it will only display the file names in case. And I want to search whether it is there or not. And rather than again showing the lines and everything, just show me the files under which we have an Apple word. Okay, that iPhone L will do. Okay. So this is very powerful and useful command in the Unix. Okay. So just grep search the values in one or more than one file. Negative search. And grep iPhone N. display. Display only file names. Okay, so the idea behind, okay, starting UNIX now, okay, because from to understand your detailed HDFS architecture will be required to know the configuration file and looking at the content of the file and all that. So people who are already comfortable on the UNIX, okay, you may ignore these just the basic commands. And people who are new to the UNIX background, maybe you can make use of them and then you can start practicing them so that you will be comfortable in the next session. Because whatever commands we are discussing now, the same commands exactly with a similar functionality with slight syntactical changes, we'll be using again them in the HDFS. So whatever commands we are discussing, so if you are comfortable with it, now you are almost 70% comfortable with your HDFS commands also, Hadoop commands also. So that way the commands are very important. Okay, so the same commands will be again using the HDFS with the different syntaxes and with the slightly different approaches. Okay.